Hello and welcome to hypothesis testing. In this lecture, what I want to do is to show you in general terms without any numbers but just visually what we do with a hypothesis test. So let's talk about what a hypothesis test is. So we start off with a null hypothesis distribution, right? So this is your null hypothesis distribution, and you have the center, right? The center is, and let me draw this out, make sure I can get this right. This is your center. Right? And this is your mean, your population mean, right? Your population mean. And so this here, it could be a population mean or it could be a population proportion if it's binomial. And this is the center, right? And this is the center for your null hypothesis distribution. Now, you take a sample, right? You take a sample, right? And before you take the sample, you have to fix your type 1 error or alpha. So you can say alpha is 5% or 1%. You got to fix that. And once you have alpha fixed, let me smooth this. Once you have alpha fixed, you need to decide whether this is a two-tailed test or a one-tailed test, right? So if your hypothesis says this change, the sample you take comes from a population where things are different or change, that's a two-tailed test, and we're going to start looking at a two-tailed test first. And therefore, then you have to distribute your alpha. You've got to put alpha by 2 and alpha by 2 because you have to look at both sides. And this point here, this is your lower critical limit. And this point here is your upper critical limit. So now we take a sample, right? And the sample could be on the left-hand side, it could be here, or it could fall here. So we don't know what the sample value is. Sample value can be greater than the mean, the population value, or it can be less than the population value. As I said, we are taking a two-tailed test. So if we get the sample mean somewhere here, if you get the sample mean somewhere here, then this area, which is to the left of the sample, that's your p-value, right? That's your p-value. If your sample mean is somewhere here, then the area, sorry, not to the left, the area to the right here, this is your p-value, area to the right. Now, you know from Excel that Excel does not give you the area, Excel norm.dist gives you probability of the left side of a line, right? So if you have data on the right side, p-value will always be 1 minus norm dist, right? Norm.dist. And why? Because alpha by 2 is on the right, so p-value also has to be in the right, and you compare your p-value with alpha by 2. Okay? Now, so p-value method compares area of sample value to alpha, or alpha by 2, right? So now let's look at the critical value method. In critical value method, we know this here is the sample, right? We know this value. This is given to us, or this value is given to us. But what we don't know is, we don't know what the critical values are. So you need to use norm.inv to find out what UCL or LCL is. The problem in norm.inv is that it asks you for a probability. So if you are, and you have here probability alpha by 2. Alpha by 2 is to the right. Remember, Excel always wants the left value, left side value. This value here, it wants this whole area, right? So you're going to do 1 minus alpha by 2 in a two-tail test. Okay, and then that'll give you this value, and you can then compare if sample value is closer to the population mean, you fail to reject. If sample value is on this side, if it's right here, then you reject your null hypothesis. Okay? So now let's focus on the left-hand side of this whole thing. So let's talk about the same thing here. And let's go to the left side. So let's assume that you get, this is alpha by 2, and this is alpha by 2, right? And let's say you did get your sample mean, and the sample mean came out here, right? This is your sample or sample value, right? So now, or it could come somewhere here, right? Whoops. Let's undo. I'm sorry. There we go. So the p-value now, the p-value automatically, this could be the p-value. Or if it's here, this is the p-value. P-value is automatically to the left. So when you do your norm.dist to get the p-value, you just have to put in, you don't have to do 1 minus. This left-hand side is just positive, right? Similarly, when you do norm.inv to get your LCL, you just have to put alpha by 2. You don't have to do 1 minus. Because here, you got to take the, to find the left-hand side, you got to do 1 minus. In the left-hand side, you don't have to do that, right? Now, the same concept applies to one-tail test. When you have a one-tail test, right, when you have a one-tail test, and let me use this as an example. Here we go. This is the example we discussed in the book. You will see that in the right-hand side, when we are calculating p-value, you're going to do 1 minus norm.dist to get the p-value. And then when you want to find out this 0.05641, when you want to find out this value, you do norm inverse 1 minus alpha, right? 1 minus alpha. But if you are going to do this on the left-hand side, you don't have to do this 1 minus, right? I hope this is clear to everybody. And this is really what I wanted to talk about in this short video. So let me summarize. So to summarize, the p-value method compares the probability, whether it's on the right-hand side or if it's on the left-hand side, right? it's the area, right? It compares this with alpha, and the critical value method essentially looks at this point and this point. This is the critical value, and it basically compares it to the sample value, okay? Now remember, sample value could be, it can be anywhere. It can be here or here, it could be here, right? It can be anywhere. So I just wanted everybody to understand the basic concept of hypothesis testing.